Now I will tell you that when a point mass is attached to a string wound over the cylinder, which is capable of rotating about its own axis, then what will be its motion? Then how to find the tension in the string? That we have to find. Tension in the... So now let's... This is the cylinder. This is not cylinder. Here we have a... This is now axis about which it can rotate with the velocity omega, and this is a string. This is the string, this is not point mass. This is not point mass. Point mass. So that its mass is m. Then its weight will act vertically downward. Mg. There will be the tension in the string, T. So as this point mass moves downward, this cylinder rotates about its own axis. So this is similar to this one, that this is now suppose the cross-sectional area of this cylinder, and this is now your string. This is now point mass M. This is now tension T. Its weight is acting vertically downward. This is now your, and this is now radius R of the cylinder. So this is now what that we have is R. This is now R. So now let's M equal to mass of point mass. And this capital M, mass of cylinder. Mass of cylinder. R, the radius of cylinder. So now, the force is acting on the forces. Forces on the point mass. Point mass. Number one, the weight and of point mass. Number second, the tension. Tension T in the string. So when this point mass is moving vertically downward, so the equation of motion will be what? The equation of motion. This is equal to your mg minus p is equal to ma. A the acceleration. So this acceleration will be vertically downward. This will be the acceleration. This is now A. This This is now equation number 1.
Now we have to find the acceleration in the body. Since the body is moving vertically downward, so it will acted upon by the torque. So the torque, now this is equal to, that we know, this is now your I into F, I the moment of inertia of this cylinder, and torque, this we know, that this is also in this, T into R is equal to I into, this is now your A upon R. We know that this I is equal to moment of inertia of cylinder, and F, angular acceleration. So now this T is equal to, know that this A is equal to, this is now your T into R square upon I. So now we can put this from equation 1. This mg minus t equal to m into this now t r square upon I. So if you take this t on this side, then this t is equal to mg equal to t into 1 plus m r square upon I. This is not so much. So now what we have to find the value of T. So this T or T equal to mg upon 1 plus mr square upon I. This is now force. Now from here you can see, if we put the value of moment of inertia, that is of the cylinder, this is now half mr square. This r is the radius of the cylinder. So this we can put for cylinder. I is equal to 1 by 2. Remember that this small m is the mass of the point mass. This is the mass of the cylinder. So if I put this value here, then what I get? This T equal to mg upon 1 plus, this is now your m r square upon 1 by 2 m r square. This r square will cancel. So this is now your 2m. Then this T is equal to mg upon 1 plus 2m upon capital M. And now you can have that this T is equal to mg upon m plus 2m. Now from here you can see that this in the denominator, m plus 2m is always more than this mg. So this what we have, that this more than this capital M. So this tension T
is always less than the weight mg of the body. So tension T conclusion, the tension in the string, tension T in a string is always less than weight of point mass. Point mass. Weight mg. So what we have? This T is less than mg. You can calculate it by keeping any of the value of this capital M and the small m. Suppose I take the example of this one. This I have taken for the cylinder. Similarly, if suppose this is given the pulley, in that case the value of this I will be equal to half mr square, because pulley is just like a disc whose moment of inertia will be half mr square. So now I take the example. Let this capital M is equal to, you would suppose 5 kg, and small m is equal to suppose 1 kg. Then what we have? The weight of the body. Weight of body. This W, this is equal to what? Mg. M is equal to 1, so this is not only g. Keeping this m equal to 1, this w is equal to g. So this is equal to only the g. The tension will be how much? T equal to, this we have taken now 5, and this is now your g upon, this is now your 5 plus, now this is 2. So this will be equal to T equal to 5 into, this is now suppose this 1G, 1G upon 7. So this 5 by 7, this factor is less than 1. Because of this, this tension will be less than this 1G. So what we have? Tension. Therefore, T is less than 1G. This will be हमेशा ही हमेशा ही टेस्ट में कितना भी पढ़ो इसके अंदर कोई. तो आप देख सकते हैं कि ये क्वेश्चन एक बार नीट में पूछा गया था. That suppose there is a body of mass 1 kg which is suspended to the string passing over the cylinder capable of rotating, then find the tension of the body when the value of g was given to there and the mass of the cylinder was given. So now on that basis we can calculate this T equal to, that will be so much. And you can remember that this T is always less than 1g, the mass, the weight of the body. So question may be asked in any way, in the NEET or in the competitive exam. So this is also very useful for the other competitive exams like the JEE, NDA, etc. So you all know, like, share and subscribe. Share the video as much as possible. So thank you very much.